That's the Red Sea of Sound, the marching band and the pep band at Winston-Salem State. They're warming up before the Livingstone Winston-Salem State game. And speaking of warming up, another rival game going on down in the ATL. That's right, Clark Atlanta Morehouse, the Cross the Street Rivals. I mean, this is rivalry show. Let's watch another big game. They're fired up. You need to be too. Clark Atlanta hosting Morehouse.
Man, I tell you, I love the Morehouse-Clark Atlanta rivalry. They're across the street from each other. They know each other. So they should have anticipated Eric Lawrence giving Alan Dempster a nice pass, and he scores. Robert Askew inside, drives, used the glass, got the foul. It's all good. This is a nice drive right here by Austin Anderson. Boom, he scores. Grady Brewer likes what he's seeing right then. He should. The game goes back and forth in the first half. Javarius Gray making it rain gives Morehouse a 29-22 lead just before the half. Joseph Hughes, left-handed three-pointer. Halftime score 38-29. Clark Atlanta dancers and cheerleaders are having a good time. I don't know why they're behind. But then again, maybe they knew something, because second half, they come out like mad, don't they? Dempster, 5 out of 5 field goal scores inside, looked like Kareem on that play. And then Dempster again goes inside and scores. Game goes back and forth. I mean, this jump shot here makes it 44-44, about 7 minutes to go. And then Morehouse just took control. They really did. Javarius Gray follows right there and scores. And then Guy, again, watch this. Stopping, popping, dropping. Tyrus Walker in the corner. Boom. When it's all said and done, Morehouse can walk back across the street, get in line with the Deltas, and win the game. 81-71, the men of Morehouse.
One of the goals is to get outside the game, outside of the court, to get our student athletes more involved, to get our member institutions more involved in community impact as part of CIAA, TLC, Tradition, Leadership, and Community. So anytime you can come together with Lowe's or any organization to support what's going on in that community, it gives us a great sense of that we're doing something to give back.
Habitat was founded in 1976 by Linda and Millard Fuller. Many people believe that Jimmy Carter founded it because he's such a huge proponent, but it was actually the Fullers. They were just two successful people who one day felt called to leave their possessions behind and found this ministry. And that was almost 40 years ago, and now we've built over 700,000 homes and have served over 1 million families in that time.
We're appreciative of the opportunity as well to come out and do this. And just on a personal level as well, I have interest in urban planning, so housing is a part of that. So just being able to come out as well and start learning, you know, about the different components to building a house, you know, even that it takes, we're happy to do that.
One thing that's big with John C. Smith is always giving back to the community. So we always want to get out and get some hours and try to help out.
We've got our own community within our own organizations here to support this initiative. So I'm just thankful. You know, I'm thankful for Lowe's that they've been able to create this space for many years, you know, to provide homes for people. And CIAA would love to continue to be a part of these types of things with our community partners.
Well, I don't guess I got to ask you who you're pulling for tonight.
You know it, LC Bears.
LC Livingstone made a lot of history last year, winning their first ever CIAA championship. You think they can do it again?
Yes, boys and girls, we're going to take it again.
The men and the women. Well, you know what? If they win another championship, maybe one of the players could be a HBCU legend in the future. You know what I'm saying?
You're right.
And you can say you told them all about it, right?
Yeah.
But what we're going to do is sit back. It's not going to be a Livingstone guy right now, but we're going to see this week's HBCU legend, all right? How you doing, LC? How you doing?
LC,
you know.
Lowe's presents HBCU Legend of the Week. Known to all as simply the Pearl, Earl Monroe captured the hearts of basketball fans like few others have. Monroe led the Winston-Salem State Rams with legendary head coach Clarence Big House Gaines to the 1967 Division II National Championship. During that 1967 season, Monroe would be named CIAA Player of the Year and National Player of the Year. Monroe would score 1,329 points his senior year, averaging 42 points a game, and his 2,935 points ranks him number one all time in CIAA history. CIAA and HBCU legend Earl the Pearl Monroe.
Thanks for watching Inside the Game, presented by Toyota. And I've got distinguished people with me. On this side, I've got Andre Springs, the AD at Livingstone, dressed in all his blue, right?
Well, you
got
to have your colors on, man.
I mean, I can't see your pants. Coordinate. See, you got to get coordinated. What's your pants? Yeah, I see. That's what happens when you win a championship. On this side, Tanya Walker, the director of athletics at Winston-Salem. And you ran fast. Tanya, I know there's a great event going on in Winston-Salem's campus pretty soon. Tell me about it.
Absolutely. The Chiefs got it covered. Classy Hat Affair. We are raising scholarship dollars for our female sports. Please join us the morning of Valentine's Day, 11:30 a.m. at the Forsyth Country Club. Tickets are $100.
$100. So if I go to that, I don't have to get a Valentine gift or anything.
Just wear your hat.
Just wear my hat? Well, I got a bow tie. I had a bow tie, so does that help me? Listen, you can hear the horn blowing, so we got to go. You guys want to see Slams of the Week?
Yes, let's see Slams.
Slams of the Week. Look at the camera and say, I want to see Slams of the Week.
I want to see Slams of the Week.
It's time for Slams of the Week, presented by Toyota.